गुड मॉर्निंग सर। गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
हाय आदित्य, गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
Good morning, everyone. After a big gap, so actually we started a theorem called binomial theorem in the last class. I think two classes finished, and this may be the last class on binomial. Next day onwards, we'll change the topic. See how we started binomial theorem. What are the topics we covered? So the long back. When I expanded x plus y whole square, x plus y whole cube, and so on, x plus y whole power 6, x plus y whole power 7. So I know this formula, but when it comes to here, I don't know what is the formula, but I can simplify. Using the Pascal triangle, I expanded this. The Pascal triangle is 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1, 1. That's called addition of both the things. Like that, using Pascal triangle, I used to expand these terms. There I got a doubt. When the power is very high, like 20, 21, 22, like that, how to expand? So to overcome that, like x plus y whole power 20, if suppose, then the terms are x power 20, y power 0. X power 19, y power 1, x power 18, y square, and so on. X power 2, y power 18, x power 1, y power 19, x power 0, y power 20. So this skeleton we can write, but when we are talking about their coefficients, it is 20c0, 20c1, 20c2, like that. Shall I discuss yesterday's paper? Question. Yes, we'll discuss. And so on. 20C18, 20C19, and the 20C20. So that is a binomial expansion. In the general case, we can write x plus y whole power n equal to NC0 x power n y power 0. NC1 x power n minus 1 y power 0. NC2 x power n minus 1 is 1 y power 2. Like NCn x power 0 y power n. Now, what are the different topics we studied and we have to study? The first one is number of terms. If the power is n, there will be n plus 1 number of terms. Next one is called general term, that is tr plus 1 is equal to ncr into x power r into y power n minus r. X power r into y power n minus r. And after writing the general term, next to middle term. Middle term is, we calculated there is a two things, n even, n odd. That is, t r by 2 plus 1 is a one thing. T r plus 1 by 2, 2 r plus 3 by 2. Now, after that, independent term. So today, once I'll recall middle terms, independent term, and the numerically greatest coefficient. The last one, when we are in the, when we start the original curriculum, there we'll start that. So these are the things we'll discuss today. Remember, I'll discuss again the middle term and the independent term and the numerically greatest coefficient. Okay. So before discussing all the things, as the students are asking, discuss yesterday's question paper. So I'm discussing the question paper, question number. But a bit fastly I'll discuss, I'll not waste the time. Question number one. Question number one. Which of the following is a quadratic equation with the roots 2 minus root 3? If one root is 3 minus root 3, other root is 2 plus root 3. If you know the two roots, then the quadratic equation is, if the root is alpha and the beta, x square, sum of the roots into x and the product of the roots equal to 0. That x square minus here sum of the roots is 6 into x plus product of the roots, just do calculate here. 3 minus 3 plus 2 root 3. It is looking like a minus b into a plus b. 2 root 3 whole square. 9 minus 4 3 is 12. That is equal to minus 3. So the equation is x square minus 6x minus 3 equal to 0. X square minus 6x minus 3 equal to 0. It is there in the option, I think. X square minus 6x minus 3 equal to 0. And the question number?
Yes, sir. There are two options, sir. Same.
B or D. Or D is also same like that. It is there. Okay. The next one. If the product of the roots is, see, x square minus 3x plus k equal to 0, product of the roots, if alpha, beta are the roots, then we'll say that the product of the roots is equal to k. And what they gave? Minus 2 they gave. Everything answers become wrong.
So it is 10.
It is 10, sir.
Yeah, yeah, oh, it's fine.
Yes, sir.
That's what I'm thinking. What answer? It's yes, a 10. Sir. So yes, the 10 sir. Will come this side. So x square minus 3x plus k minus 10 equal to 0. So product of the roots is nothing but k minus 10 is equal to minus 2 they give. 1 minute I got shocked. Everything. So k equal to 10 minus 2, that is equal to 8. Question number 2. Number 3 words. Question number 3. In a quadratic equation, 9x square plus ax minus 2. Ax minus 2 is equal to 10, 2 is equal to 10, find the value of A for which x is equal to 1 by 3, is its solution. Find the value of A if x is equal to 1 by 3 is the solution. In a quadratic equation, 9x square plus ax minus 2 equal to 10, x is equal to 1 by 3 is the solution. Keep x equal to 1 by 3, 9 into it is 1 by 9, plus a into it is 1 by 3, minus 2 is equal to 10. 1 plus a by 3 is equal to, it will become 12. So a is equal to 12 minus 1, that is equal to 11, a by 3. Therefore, a is equal to 33. For 3 only they give. Actually, it is not 10. It is
there 6. Is no answer in the option.
Yes. Okay, I'll check it. Yes, I'll discuss with them. I'll discuss with the board work. So actually, it is 0, I think. Okay, any question? 33 is the answer. Na? I will discuss with you. No, don't worry.
Yes, sir.
So the question number 4. What is the value of k for which the roots of the quadratic equation 3x square 2kx plus 27 equal to 0, the roots are real and equal. So whenever the roots are real and equal, the condition is b square minus 4ac should be equal to 0. B square minus b is nothing but 4k square. A value 3, this is 27. Equal to 0. That is 4k square is equal to 4 into 3 into 27. 4 getting cancelled. K square is equal to 81. So k is equal to plus 9 or minus 9. K is equal to plus 9 or minus 9. That's a question number 4.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, can you show the previous board again?
I'll show it. Check it, please. See, what you have to do now, whenever question paper you are solving, so whenever the discussion is going on, you have to maintain a one book. Or else, at the back of the notes, the back page of the notes, you should turn the book. That is usually we used to do. That said, we have to write question paper discussions. Question paper number, date, what are the doubt problems you have? You have to solve the question and the solution. That will be very good. So after 1 year, you will write nearly so many exams. So many bulk of questions, solutions you will have. That's why my request is, whenever exam is finished, whenever paper is discussion is going on, okay, try to copy the problems what you are not able to solve in the examination. That's it.
Yes, I'm done.
Yeah, the next one. Number 5. Question number 5, the nature of a roots of the quadratic equation 25x square minus 49 equal to 0. And definitely we can calculate the roots 49. X square equal to 49 by 25. X is equal to plus or minus 7 by 5. The roots are real and distinct. Roots are real and distinct. Now, the roots of the equation 3x square minus 2 root x plus 2 equal to 0. The same question we solved. Have you remembered or not? The same question we solved.
Yes, sir.
3x square. It can be written as a root 3x whole square. 2 into root 3 into root 3x into root 2 plus root 2 whole square equal to 0. It is like a square minus 2ab plus b square equal to 0, root 3x minus root 2 whole square equal to 0. This is only the better and best idea. So root 3x minus root 2 equal to 0, root 2 by root 3. Since both roots are same, root 2 by root 3.
Sir, can you explain the 5th number again?
Everyone will say roots are real, no real roots means b square minus 4ac less than 0. But look at c, c here minus c is there, na? So minus into minus plus, it's become b square plus 4ac less than 0. Next question, ROSC rose. The number of 4-letter words formed with the letters of the word rose, where repetition is not allowed. Whenever the repetition is not allowed, the first blank can be filled in 4 ways, 3 ways, 2 ways, 1 way. 4 3s are 12, 12 2s are 24, 24 number of ways. Pop it.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, that 7 number once again, you can explain it.
7 number. Actually, no roots, no real root means condition what? Imaginary roots. Imaginary roots, the condition is what? B square minus 4ac?
Less than 0.
B square minus 4ac less than 0. There, B square minus 4ac less than 0. I thought every student will pick the answer. That intentionally I changed c as a minus c. That means this c become minus c. This minus will come here. B square plus 4ac less than 0. No one will take this because I gave like that. So b square plus 4ac less than 0 because of that minus.
Yes, sir.
Roach is easy question. We solved so many times. Finished?
Yes, sir.
See, if anyone want to copy, have a copy. I'm repeating again. Sir, whenever we are preparing for these competitive exams, nothing, if this is the notes, we used to turn it back. First, test one. Date of the respective paper. Okay. No need, if 15 questions are solved there, no need to solve 15 questions. What are the doubt questions? That question numbers. That is a point number one. And the point number two, some stick files will be there. Stick files or any big files. In that file, you have to keep the question paper. What you people are doing, I know that. Now it is a, since it is a online mode, no problem. When we are studying in the offline mode, they used to give you one paper. We used to file it. After end of the 1 year, first year syllabus they'll complete, and first year whole question papers we used to have. No need to buy any other books. These questions are enough. Those question papers are enough. Those question paper solutions will be there at the back of our notes. See how perfect a design it is. I used to do like that. If you want to do, it's better to do like that. Since it is an online paper, no problem. Somewhere store it. Keep it in your mail or somewhere. Yes, next question is. Question number 9. The number of two-digited even numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the repetition is not allowed. When I ask two-digited even numbers, this blank can be filled in either with 2 or with 4. That is two ways. If I fill with 2, remaining 4 numbers are baki. Therefore, this blank can be filled in 4 ways. 4 twos are 8 ways. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the numbers. First blank can be, since I'm asking even number, first blank can be filled in 2 ways, either with 2 or with 4. If I filled with 2, any one of the number remains 4 numbers, the second blank can be filled in 4 number of ways. Question number 10. The number of 4-letter words formed with first 10 letters of English alphabets. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. There are the 10 letters of English alphabet. So they are asking four letter word. Whenever 10 letters are there, whenever you are writing four letter word, it is nothing but 10p4. Among 10, you have to pick up 4 and you have to arrange. Or that can also be done in, first blank can be done in 10 ways, second blank can be done in 9 ways, next in 8 ways, next in 7 ways. Since the calculation will take the much time, so I gave in a simplified form called 10p4. Next, number 11. 4 factorial is equal to, that is equal to 4 into 3 into 2, that is equal to 24. 24. Question number 12. Here onwards, questions are easy. Question number 12, it is 6 factorial minus 5 factorial. Calculate 6 factorial. 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So this is 24. 24 5s are 120. 126 is 720. Therefore, it is 720 minus 5 factorial 120. I think it is 600. 600 is the answer.
Yes, sir.
Question number 13.
Yes, sir.
The number of ways of arranging 6 persons in 4 chairs. 6 persons, 4 chairs. So I clearly gave the word arranging. See, that's why 13 and 14 questions side by side I gave. In the 13 question, you can see the word arrange. That is nothing but 6p4. I'll calculate. And the 14th question, the number of ways selecting 6 persons among 6 persons among 4 persons, that is called 6p4. Sir, I want my students should know the difference between those two things. That's why I created those two problems like that. The words are arrange and select. Side by side I give, so that they can understand where we should use permutation and where we should use combination. 6 persons are there. 4 chairs are there. We have to arrange in 6p4 ways. 6p4 ways. Or 6 persons are there. 4 persons I should select. It is 6c4 ways. Here I want to, what are the options I gave in terms of numbers? Yeah. I gave in terms of numbers. See, the 6p4 formula is 6 factorial by 4 factorial. That's enough. Yeah. I'll write in the next verse. One is 6p4. One is 6p4. Second one is 6e4. 6 factorial by 4 factorial. This is 6 factorial by 4 factorial into 2 factorial. Okay. The number of arranging 6 persons into 4 chairs. That is equal to.
So 360.
360 is coming.
Yes, sir.
So 2 factorial. So six factorial by two factorial.
That's what I'm thinking. What I'm getting. Yes, correct. You are correct, boy. Exactly, you're correct. Six factorial by two factorial.
2 factorial.
That is 720 by. That's what I'm thinking. By 2, that is equal to 360. Exactly correct. And here you can do it.
Yes, sir. 15.
Those are the two questions. And the last one, intentionally I gave 12p2. Actually, I gave the question like 2p6. This is the actual question. Again, I confused whether the boys or girls, they can do it or not. That's why I changed the question. 12p2 means easily you can do it. 12 factorial by 10 factorial like that. Okay. But actually the question is 2p6. Can we calculate the options? I gave something B, C, and the option D I gave as a none. There you have to tick answer as a none. Why? Because 2p6 is not defined.
Because 6 is greater.
Ah, that is the original number, but I changed it. Okay. Na? So among those are the question paper, and this is the 100% easy question paper. if the next time, yes, definitely sir. I'll give a bit hard question paper. If anyone or finish, if anyone want to copy anything, please you can. So it's there in the 9 to 15 questions. Completed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. How is the climate there at your place? The floods are like a cyclone went off, or still it is like that?
No, sir. Cyclone.
Oh. Okay. Corona cases, everything is okay. Now it is in order.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Still lockdown is there at your place?
Yes, sir. Lockdown is there. It extended up to 17.
17, yes, sir.
17 June, huh?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What are the timings like in here? Na, we can move till 12 only, after 12 lockdown. Yes,
so 6 to 12,
like that for ourselves.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Any cost, stay safe. Be safe. Now, see, as I said, the next one. It is a binomial theorem. Once I'll recall middle term. So the thing is, if n is even, and second one, n is odd, two cases. If n is even, number of terms is equal to odd. The number of terms is equal to odd. Then the formula is T n by 2 plus 1. So we should talk about R, Baba. It's R. It's a T R by 2 plus 1. In the same way, if R is odd, number of terms is equal to even. The formula is T R plus 1 by 2, comma T R plus 3 by 2. An example, x plus 2 whole power 16, find middle term. You should write, given n is equal to 16, comma, number of terms is are odd, odd in number, plus the expansion has, suppose, how many middle terms now? Since it is even, has one middle term. So that is T n only. N is even, n is odd. So T, it is n only, it is not R. T n by 2 plus 1, that is equal to T 16 by 2 plus 1, that is equal to 8 plus 1, that is equal to T9, ninth term. So when you are writing ninth term, the general term we expanded. So when you are writing the ninth term, it is 16C8 into, am I correct? If it is 9, we should write 8. 16C8 into x power 16 minus 8 into 2 power 8, that is 16C8 into x power 8 into 2 power 8. That's it. No need to expand it. In the same way, when I am talking about another example, x plus y whole power 20, x plus 1, yeah, x plus x minus 2 whole power 23 find the middle term. So we should write like that. Since n is equal to 23 is odd number, comma, expansion has even number of terms. That expansion has even number of terms. So it has two middle terms. It has two middle terms. The first one is t n plus 1 by 2, comma t n plus 3 by 2. T is equal to 23 plus 1 by 2, comma 23 plus 3 by 2. That is t 12, comma t 13. So t 12, how to calculate? 23 c 11, we should decrease it by 1, Baba. 20 c x power, ye donon ko subtraction into minus 2 whole power 11. That is 23 c 11 into x power, how much? 12, x power 12 into 2 power 11. Just imagine where that minus is gone. The minus we should write here. Why? Because minus power odd number. In the lake, when we are talking about T13, it is called 13th term. 13th term. Its formula is 23 C12. We should write 20 C T12. X power 23 minus 12 into minus 2 whole power 12. Minus 2 whole power 12. So it will become 23 C12 into X power, how much it is? 11, into 2 power 12. Since negative power even number is there, the minus will go off. The minus will go off. That is the how to calculate the middle terms. Right? Please copy the question number, example 1 and example 2. Those who are new to the class, please write this note also. If you are not able to understand, maybe in the certain reason, like you are absented for the previous class, anything, please let me know. I'll explain it again. Middle term. I'm repeating. If anyone new to the class, please ask me. I'll explain it again. If anyone missed the last class, if you are not able to join at that time, please let me know. I'll explain it again.
So please explain the middle term theorem again.
Very good.
Yes, sir. Yes.
And the remaining persons, those who understood, please copy it. And those who are not there, I'm explaining soon. Sir, the topic name is called binomial theorem. You know that. In that, I am talking about middle term. See, in the expansion of x plus y whole power 6, there will be 7 terms. Term 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So what is the middle term? Na? These three, if I cancel, this become middle term. Name itself is same. That's what I am concluding. If power 6, it is an even number, you have a 7 number of terms, odd number of terms. If odd number of terms comes, there will be only one middle term. That only I wrote. If n is even, that is 6 is even, we'll get odd number of terms. Number of terms equal to odd. Matlab, 7 terms we have. So the middle term, there is only one middle term. Its formula is t n by 2 plus 1. Now 6 by 2, how much? 6 by 2, 3. 3 plus 1, 4. Look at the fourth term. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the formula, generalized formula. This is an example. If you want, I'll repeat it again. See, if the power is 16, suppose. If the power is 16, there will be 17 number of terms. Since it is even, 17 is odd number. Since it is even, 17 is an odd number. 17 is an odd number. So it will have only one middle term since it is odd number. The middle term formula is 16 by 2 plus 1. 16 by 2, 8, 8 plus 1, 9. So, ninth term is the middle term. Like that, I did the first question. The example number 1. X plus Y whole power 16. Find the middle term. Given n equal to 16, since it is an even number, the number of terms are odd in number. Therefore, odd number of terms we have. Implies the expansion has one middle term. I said as a one middle term. That formula is T n by 2 plus 1. Now, n value is 16 they gave. 16 by 2 plus 1. So, 8 plus 1, ninth term. So, this is a general term. It lacks classes. If it is 9, we should write 8. If it is 9, we should write 8. It is 16 C8 into x power 16 minus 8 and 2 power 8. They are x and 2. That is 2 power 8 is equal to 5. Sir, if it is n odd number, what will happen? If n is odd number, the next, so copy. First, I will give the time. Sir. If n is odd number, then the number of terms will be even. For example, I am saying, sir, x plus y whole power 8 is 7 is there. Then the, we have a 8 number of terms. 8 terms. Among 8 terms, the middle term will be, there will be 2 number of middle terms. What term? 4th term and 5th term. So the formula is, the middle terms are t n plus 1 by 2 and the t n plus 3 by 2. Those are the middle terms. So the formula is T23 plus 1 by 2, T23 plus 3 by 2. That is T12 and T14, T13. And the T12, I wrote 23C11. Common. T13, 23C12 into C. General time formula I'm writing. TR plus 1 equal to NCR into X power. A donon ka subtraction into Y power R. That is a general term. Using the general term, I wrote those two. Going to simplify it, it is enough to leave it like that. Is it okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah,
please copy it. Those who asked me the doubt, copy this term and the next term. First. Completed.
Yes, sir. Next page, sir.
Yes.
The next, please copy it.
Completed, sir.
Completed?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the next one. And the one question I'm giving the work, please try to do these questions. First one. 1 plus x whole power 13. Calculate middle terms. This is the work to you all. 1 minus x whole power 14. Calculate the middle terms. Afterwards, write a question and leave it like that. D, R, F. This is a work to you all. Please try to do it. 1 plus x whole power 13. One is even, another is odd. Now, keep your pens down and open your minds on my screen. Please, your pens down. Independent term, very important topic, independent term. So what is called independent term? In the expansion of 1 plus x whole power 20, suppose, example I'm saying, in the expansion of 1 plus x whole power 20, sir, in here, what is the variable? We can say that variable is x. I'm asking, Aditya, is there another girl? I'm asking, expand it. They expand it like that. They'll get 21 terms. See, among the 21 terms, there is a one term here. You are able to, it's a 20C10, suppose. 20C10, x power 10 into 1 by x whole power 10, both get cancelled. 20C10 is coming. So entire term, there is no variable. We can see that. The variables are getting cancelled. Right, if I'm talking about the first term, 20C0 into x power 20, there x is there. Second term, 20C1 into x power 19 into 1 by x, that is x power 8, x power 18 it's coming. There also x is there, but when I'm going term by term, at a particular incident, particular thing, the x1, they're getting cancelled and we are getting a term without x. So that is called independent term. It is not dependent. It's called independent term. How to write? In the expansion of any binomial term, in the expansion of any binomial term, comma, a term without variable or variable power 0 is called, variable power 0 is called independent term. Variable power is called independent term. Example. Suppose tr plus 1 is equal to ncr into x power n minus r into 2 power r. I'm writing tr. Yes. In the expansion of x plus 1 by x whole power 20 comma 10th term is equal to 10th term what 11th term is equal to 1 should decrease na 11th term is equal to 20C10 into x power 20 minus 10 into 1 by x whole power 10, that is 20C10 into x power 10 into 1 by x whole power 10, they both are getting cancelled. 20C10. There we have to write a one note. No variable. We have to write no variable or variable power 0. Anything you can write. So that is only called independent term. Implies T11 is an independent term. That is called independent term. Okay, please copy it. Keep the heading called independent term and copy it.
Yes, sir.
Completed, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir. Completed.
Yeah.
Completed, sir.
Very good. Let others write, please. Other people, please write and I'll wait for you.
Completed, sir.
Very good.
Completed, sir.
Very good.
Sir, can you explain this again, that example?
Yeah. Sure. Thank you. See, in the expansion of x plus 1 by x whole power 20, it is 20. I just casually asked what is the 11th term. Then my friend Aditya, he started, sir, you want 11th term? It is 20 C10 into x power 20 minus 10 into 1 by x whole power 10. So it is 20 C10 into x power 10 into 1 by x power 10. 1 by x power. There x power 10 is getting cancelled. So you got answer as a 20 C10. Actually, when we are expanding, it is x plus 1 by x. There the variable is x. But after writing the 11th term, the variable is getting cancelled. Yeah, the variable is getting cancelled. And you are getting a simple number called 20 C10. That's why I wrote in the cloud. That is my cloud. No variable, but or variable power 0. Okay. So, since there is no x there, we can say that T11 is an independent term. T11 is an independent term. Okay. Now, one more. If you want, I will wait. The question is, find the independent term in the expansion of x square plus 1 by x whole power 10. The question is that. Find the independent term in the expansion of x square plus 1 by x whole power 10. How to calculate independent terms? So very important, very alarming question. First, right, we know that general term is equal to, what is a general term, Baba? Tr plus 1 is equal to 10 cr into x square whole power 10 minus r into 1 by x whole power r. Am I correct? That is equal to 10 cr into x power, both multiply it. We have a formula. A power m, whole power m is a power mn. Like 20 minus 2r into 1 by x whole power r. That is 10 cr into, this can be, this is 20 minus 2r into 1 by x power r. A power m by a power n, it is equal to a power m minus n, like that. 10c r into x power 20 minus 3r. 20 minus 3r. Now, what is called independent term? Independent term means x power should be 0. What is x power? 20 minus 3r is equal to 0. 20 minus 3r is equal to 0. Therefore, 20 is equal to 3r implies r is equal to 20 by 3. See, we are talking about n, r. These are simple natural numbers. R can be 5, r can be 6 like that. R cannot be 20 by 3. It's a decimal, na? R cannot be 20 by 3. So, conclusion is, there is no independent term in the given expansion. That's a good question. Actually, everyone, after getting R value, everyone will start writing the independent term. But what I can say that, whenever you are writing the number of term, it's a third term, sixth term, 20th, like that we'll say. But we never say 16.1 term, 2 by 3 term. We will never say that. So, whenever you are getting R as a 20 by 3, you should conclude there, master. R never be like that. So, there is no independent term in the given expansion. Okay, please copy it. The next question will do it.
Yes, sir.
Oh, very good.
Yes, sir. Completed.
I'll wait. Please, reminding people, copy it.
Sir, complete.
Wait. Very good.
Yes, sir. Completed.
Completed.
Very good. Completed.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Fine, guys, those who are writing, you should respond. I'm waiting for you. Now, the next question is, can you please do it? The question is, in the expansion of x square plus 1 by x, wait. X square plus 1 by x whole power, just give a time to me. I'll end the question. 16. In the expansion of x square plus 1 by x whole power 24. Find the independent term. Please, can you do it? Right, dudes. Those who know how to solve, you can solve it. Those who didn't understand how to calculate the independent term, please have a look on my board. General term is equal to TR plus 1.
Per eighth term.
Very good. 1 by x square whole power r into 1 by x whole power 24 minus r. No, I wrote wrong. I wrote in reverse order. X square whole power 24 minus r into x square whole power 24 minus r into 1 by x whole power r. That is 24 cr into x power multiplied 48 minus 2r into 1 by x power r. X power 48 minus 3r, like as it is. When we are calculating independent term, when we are calculating independent term, 48 minus 3r is equal to 0.
So 48 by 3.
So 3r is equal to 48. R is equal to 48 by 3. 3 ones are?
So 16.
16 are. So r is equal to 16. Now which term? It is not 16th term. It is a 7th term.
Yes, sir. 17.
R plus 1. So independent term is 17th term.
Yes, sir.
That is T17 is equal to 24 C16. That's what remaining terms are getting cancelled. The expansion of x square plus 1 by x whole power 24. Find the independent term is the question. Okay. Please copy it. If you're not able to understand, please let me know. I'll repeat. If you switch quietly like that, I can't do anything. No?
Yes, sir. Done.
Completed, sir.
Yes. Yeah, that's the class for today. And again, in the next session, we'll meet.
Numerically greatest.
Numerically greatest coefficient. After that, numerically greatest. That's again in the curriculum. It is there. We'll go. Since it is a now pre-classes, na. So I want to introduce one more new chapter to you all. So next class with a new topic, I'll come in front of. Thank you very much. Be safe.
Thank you, sir.
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 Last one, first and student.